This week has 7 days, and we're starting with a bang. Jean Freeman's on the loose again to party with her gang. She's had a stellar year and really wants to thank us all for our support. So let's just have a ball. This week has 7 days, and this evening's so sublime. Let's take a minute, all reflect, turn back the hands of time. To Weyburn on a playground where she'd order kids around directing skits. A passion had been found. Growing and evolving, how we watched that passion grow. Oratory, movies, books, to theater she'd go. Now in Yorkton, writing ads and learning all she could, she kept her goals, progressing like she should. Off to the Queen City, where she hit CKTV, directing, writing, acting with an attitude of glee. She loved it here, but there was one thing she had to fulfill, and that day came when she married Bill. 3 children graced their lives, and they had 51 great years, and so much more in store for Jean, some laughter and some tears. And if I tell you all she's done, we'll all be here till 3. Catch up with Jean at her place when she's free. This week had 7 days, and what a way to start a week. This year's honors you've deserved, you've really hit the peak. And you'll stay there for many years, a chief we knew you would. To Jean the Queen, we all think you done good. We all think you done good.
And of course, I couldn't call together all the people who have ever had an influence on my life. So you tonight are here as your stand-ins for everybody I've ever met in my life. Some of you are here because you're helping me to stay healthy. Some of you are here because you're helping me to stay happy. There are musicians here who just make me want to live even another 100 years. There's my editor over there who has just brought me a brand new book, just hot off the press. We're launching a book tonight, quite accidentally.
I was thinking a little bit on the drive over here, as I was heading to the wrong place, of what impact Jean has had on my life. And we start thinking about the people who make an impression in your life that are memorable. And I was thinking that some people come into your life and they're memorable because they hit your life like a hurricane. They just come in and turn your world upside down and they depart, but you still remember them for a long time. Other people, much like Jean, are sort of not like a hurricane, more like a gentle breeze that comes in and, you know, when she comes across, you go, oh, open up the windows, we want more of that inside. We want more of that breeze. There's a windbag joke in here somewhere. But I'm too polite to make it. As Jean mentioned, we have videographers here. This is going to be on YouTube, I understand. This is going to be on YouTube. So I assumed that the entertainment tonight would be fluffy kittens and skateboarders being hit in the crotch. But apparently not. So, okay, good.
Just look on it this way. Look on it this way. I could have asked any one of you to open and just be grateful that it was Doug that took the... He took the bullet, he bit it for all of you. I said that you all have to fill in to represent the people in my life. So Doug is representing every time I ever had to stand up to introduce something, particularly for a friend, you know, when Lynn Goldman calls and says, I need an MC for fill in the blank. You don't say, oh, somebody else could go. No, you bite the bullet. All right, I think we are... This is a wonderful group called the Ministry of Groove.
life members of Regina Little Theater. It was an amazing thing to meet Jean. And then here's my quip story of the evening. For some reason, I had gone home to visit my parents who live in Weyburn. Did you get the connection so far? And I don't know what possessed me to, but we went through the bookcase and I managed to get out my father's old yearbooks from the Weyburn Collegiate Institute. I don't quite remember which year it was, and for reasons of politeness, I just won't even say or guess. But I am paging through and going, oh yeah, there's Dad, big deal, and I'm looking at the school, because I grew up in Weyburn, I went to the same high school many years later, and I'm kind of looking through and looking at the pictures and all that stuff, and lo and behold, thunderstruck am I as I find a picture of Jean Freeman in my father's yearbook. And what is she doing in this picture? I don't quite remember, but it was labeled Jean Freeman directing production with the Drama Club. What a surprise. I've been very happy to perform with and for Jean over the years. We actually did an episode of MythQuest together, where we both got to dress in Renaissance Italian garb, which was really, really hot, which was fine because we were shooting it in the third week of January, where we were having a little cold spell. She's also, as you all well know, Fitzy's grandmother. I mean, yay, Fitzy's grandmother. It's been such a pleasure, and I have to say, my one other memory that I really do want to share is, for 5 years in a row, the simply Herculean efforts that she would put on for Regina Little Theater. At the beginning of our season, we had been in the habit of doing a fundraising show just to sort of get the ball rolling and make everybody feel good about the season, and it was called Radio Rides, and they were radio skits and plays from the days gone by. And she looked them all up. She rewrote them to match the people that we had available to do those particular sketches. She directed the whole thing, and she emceed the show. Now, if that doesn't give you some indication of the level of energy that this woman works on, I can't even begin to start describing it to you. Yes, that's right. Overachievement, she says, and she would be right. So, on this, the not quite occasion of your 100th birthday, I'd like to say congratulations. And thank you for having me up to say a couple of words, because I'm really proud to be able to say that and to know you. And it is my pleasure to introduce the next part of our show, who is our cowboy poet, Mr. Ken Mitchell.
This is called Hell in Moose Jaw. The devil in hell, we're told, was chained for 1,000 years, and he there remained. But he didn't moan, and he complained, and he didn't moan, but determined he'd start a hell of his own, where he could torture the souls of men without being stuck in a prison pen. So he asked the Lord if he had on hand any scraps left over when he made the land. The Lord thought hard. The Lord thought long, and he said, well, there is Saskatchewan. So the devil came up and checked it well, and he said, it's too hot even for hell. But in order to get it off his hands, the Lord promised the devil he'd water the land. For he had some water that was of no use. It gave him the runs and smelt like the deuce. So the deal was made. The land was given. The Lord went back to his home in heaven. The devil had all the crap he needed to make a great hell, and he sure succeeded. He brought in mosquitoes and filled the sky and mixed the dust with alkali, scattered sow thistles along the road and filled the sloughs with hives and toads, wood tick bites, hornet stings. The hopper flies by on buzzing wings. The gophers prevail, and so do the ants. You want to sit down? You need soles in your pants. The heat in the summer's 110, too hot for the devil. Too hot for men. But it's even worse at 60 below when your brass monkeys freeze and the blizzards blow. And if that don't finish you off real quick, the gumbo in April will do the trick. It's a perfect place for sinners to dwell. It's one hell of a place, this Moose Jaw hell. My hometown. Thank you.
Jeannie and I once shared an office at CKCK Television when the station was just 5 years old. That was the beginning of a beautiful friendship, but it could have been the end. Jeannie kept cookies and things in her desk drawers, so we had regular visits from mice. On the other hand, on my birthday, she wrapped the office in teletype paper, printed in large letters, "Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, dear Lynn, happy birthday to you." It's hard to stay mad at someone like Jeannie. We've been in plays together, produced fashion shows together, done tributes to friends together, and praised the College Avenue campus together. I never shared her husband, however, or her cancer, although sometimes I've shared her children. To my knowledge, we've never shared a lover, but I could be wrong. Then, too, with Carol Gabel and Mossy Hancock, we were a quirky quartet on CBC Radio for about 15 years with That's Entertainment. I started to list the organizations and projects we've worked on over the years, and the list got very long. It includes the Saskatchewan Arts Board, CBC, Cable Regina, now Access Communications, Canada's Centennial in 1967, Regina Little Theatre, Festival of Words, Beth Jacobs Synagogue, Government House, Regina Women's Network, ACTRA, CFUW, and of course, the University of Regina. We've been to a number of weddings, bar mitzvahs, and birthday parties, and a lot of funerals. I thought we'd been friends for over 50 years or so, but time whips by so fast, it turns out to be 100 years in all. Amazing. I think we look pretty good in spite of it. Happy birthday, Jeannie.
Somebody took a look at the pages that I brought up here and said, "That's a speech." But you know, it's not so much a speech as it's an opportunity for me to share my thoughts with such a good friend. And you know what they say, you wish you would have said things that you never said and you never got the chance to say. So this is my chance to say to you how I feel. 100 years, happy birthday, Jean Freeman. You realize what that means. You are now eligible to have your face on a Smucker's Jam label and have your attributes and idiosyncrasies briefly outlined by Willard Scott on the NBC Today Show. 100 years. Well, Lynn and I have known and loved you for more than 100 years. That's between us, of course. Okay. Among, no, between you and me. Well, among, if I include Jean. I was just referring to you and me. We still are keepers of the English language. I first met Jeannie in the 1950s. I was at a Lions Band rehearsal in a classroom at Strathcona School. When out on the playground there arose such a clatter, we all sprang to the window to see what was going on. There were four male drummers marching along, and sandwiched in the middle was a young lady vigorously clashing her cymbals up and down, up and down. We asked our band director, "Who is that girl clashing her cymbals up and down?" He replied, "Oh, she's a new girl in town, from Weyburn, I think, and her name is Jean Arnott." That was my introduction to Jean. We didn't become fast friends immediately, but our lives were destined to take similar paths, and we quite often found ourselves bound together by circumstance. We both followed careers in the media. We both married musicians. Our husbands, Bill Freeman and Vern Bell, played in several bands together. They toured together with Mark Kenny and his Western Gentlemen. Where's Pat? Is she still here? Oh, she left, of course. And shows like the Lipizzan Horse Show, and they became friends and roommates on the road. Our son Brett and Jeannie and Bill's son Mitchell were born 6 months apart and grew up together on the 2300 block of Retallick Street in the Lions Band and at CKCK Television. They performed in plays together, all at Jeannie's insistence, and served as altar boys in church. They became the best of friends, and Mitchell is one of our grandson's Ben's names. He is among six. He has six names. He's named after everybody in the family because he's the last one. Hopefully. Our families did many things together throughout the years. We trekked through the snow on Christmas Eve, serenading friends and strangers with beautiful and slightly out of tune renditions of Christmas carols. And we banged pots and pans on New Year's Eve to keep away the evil spirits. We watched our children march Moose Jaw's Golden Mile at the annual band festival. We celebrated their birthdays and their achievements. Jeannie Lynn and I have also shared many moments, events, and happenings throughout the years. We did reviews for a show on CBC called That's Entertainment. I didn't realize we had such a long run, 15 years. We've emceed events, strutted our stuff for fashion shows. You can interpret stuff however you want. And performed on stage and television. But perhaps our greatest bonding came when we three were cast in the Regina Little Theatre production of Steel Magnolias. Oh, thank you so much. You love us. You really love us. One bond we certainly shared was the ever-present fear of forgetting our lines at that particular stage of our lives. I admire Jean Freeman and all her accomplishments. Certainly, she has achieved more in her lifetime than most people dream of. Broadcaster, television star, novelist, playwright, director, producer, and more. She always has been in the forefront, never afraid to speak her mind and defend what she believes in and knows to be true. She has been recognized with many awards, in fact, so many this past year, I told her, please, Jeannie, cut back. I'm running out of wardrobe to wear to all your events. But most important, I feel very fortunate to call Jean Freeman friend. She always has been there for me, whether I'm phoning her about how to cook something or when something serious is going on in my life and I need a good, solid shoulder and reassurance that the sun will come out tomorrow. I will never forget that she accompanied me and my family to Quebec City to smile and be there for me when I received the Order of Canada. That's what Jeannie does. We have shared so many good times and we have so many memories. We have laughed, cried, enjoyed life, met challenges, and persevered. Jeannie's caring, compassion, and understanding make her a very special human being. She loves to share her wisdom and experience. Just ask the countless young people she has so graciously mentored. Jeannie, you have left an indelible imprint on so many hearts and so many lives. As we celebrate the grand occasion of your 100th birthday, just a minute, I raise my glass to you, Jean Freeman, brim full of admiration, respect, and above all, love, to Jeannie. And now, it is our pleasure, Lynn's, mine, and Jeannie's, among the three of us, right, to introduce the inimitable David McIntyre.
First introduction to Jean was when she was 10 years old, and I was just born. And apparently it was a big thing in our house, boy in the family, and that sort of thing. And she must have thought I was pretty special, too, because she charged her friends to come and see me. So you can see her, in the early days, she was still quite an entrepreneur even then. Jean has always had my back. She's always had my welfare and my well-being at heart. I'm recalling an occasion. My aunt actually came to live with us when I was very young in Weyburn to look after me while my mom and dad worked. And Jean and this aunt, Ruth, got together, and they were going to cook up something on the stove. I'm not sure what it was. Something very sweet anyway, and that thing broke and bubbled all over and caused a lot of smoke. And I don't know, the police, the fire department were closed or called, but anyway. So she was worried that A, mom and dad were going to find out about it, and B, that I was going to succumb to the smoke that was filling our apartment. So she whisked me off to the furthest end of the apartment and got me laying on the bed and a thing on my face, and I survived. So I really appreciated that. You've heard already about Jean going to Yorkton, and that's kind of where I think her career in broadcasting and media and later the arts really all began. And she left home at a relatively early age to pursue her goals, but we still kept in touch. And when we were living in Yorkton, she paid, and I don't know what she was drawing down as a wage at that point, probably wasn't princely, paid out of her own pocket for me to have music lessons. And unfortunately, I wasn't sort of super great. Seeing and hearing David tonight, I kind of think maybe I should have stuck with it. In the time I was taking lessons, I only learned two songs. One was Blue Danube, the other one was God Save the Queen. And I got to play one of those at a recital, and then I retired. I can also credit Jean with my first paid gig. You've heard about her work in radio and so on. I don't remember the title of the play on radio, but she got me a bit part, and I actually got paid for it. And I thought that was kind of neat to actually get paid for doing something that really seemed lots of fun. A little family roll call. You, of course, know Bill and his work in the arts and passing away a few years ago. Thinking of the oldest son, Jack, and you're going to be treated to a video montage or historic selection of family pictures to finish off the evening. So he and his wife, Anne, and their daughter, Tina, certainly much a part of Jean's life and her family consideration. Willa, of course, who lives in Regina and would be here tonight except that she was working, and her son, Jared, I know very important to Jean as well. And an evening of talking about the Freemans can't go on without talking about Mitch and the unfortunate circumstances that took him from us. But I'd like to think Mitch is looking down on us tonight, being very proud of his mom for 100 years of pretty sturdy existence. Some things around the Freeman home in those years, I think, kind of impressed me. One was it seemed to be the hub of whatever was going on. There was either cookie decorating or there was people visiting and things happening going on, band practice, that sort of thing. Always something happening. I remember many Christmas Eves. Two phrases that have ever been emblazoned on my memory. One is, some assembly required, and batteries not included. So I can remember occasions when Bill was up until well after midnight trying to put together some kind of a toy that required a lot of assembly. And then in the morning we'd find out that the batteries we have were this big and they were needed to be. But anyway, we always had a good time at Christmas. Then there's stuff I can't read. Well, I can blame it on my glasses too, but that's another story. Again, fond memories of the Freeman family. And as I said, Jean always had my back, and I like to think that I've always had her back in terms of supporting her. And in addition to the success she's achieved in her lengthy career, certainly family has always been an important part of that equation. So I would like to just close my portion of this by saying thank you, Jean, for the occasion when we all get together and have this opportunity. You've heard about the video from Jack, which we'll see in a minute, but I must also say that Kevin Kasha is apparently a very good trumpet player, and he's going to come on right now.
Now, I've got one more story, and it's Billy. We all love Billy, and Gene's husband Bill, and whenever we could play together, it was an absolute joy, and he was a wonderful man to be around, and everyone that knew him thought the same thing for sure. But we went out to Expo 86 together with the Bob Moyer Big Band, and Jack and his dad were rooming in the same room in bunk beds. Bill was on the bottom, Jack was on the top, and one night Jack came running out. "I've killed my dad, I've killed my dad." The bunk bed collapsed on top of Bill. Jack was on the top bunk, boom, right down on top of Bill. And rather than lifting the bed off, he just ran running around talking about him killing his father. So, anyways, they all survived, yeah. So, thanks for welcoming us into your family. And we're treasured by that. So, Gene, I'm surprised, David, you got asked to perform, because I was told I was performing, you know, so you had a choice, I guess, but Jean asked me, and she says, I want this played at my funeral, but I won't be there to hear it, so why don't we have it a little bit early? So we're going to do that, and you all know the words, and I'm not sure why I'm here as a singer, because there's lots of singers and who've been here, but anyways, we're going to sing a song, and you all know the words, so you can certainly help me out. And then Jack's video will close the first half of the 100th birthday party, and we'll be back in a few years for the second half of the birthday party. Yes.
I see trees of green, red roses too, and I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, yes, what a wonderful world. I see skies blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, yes, what a wonderful world. Everybody, the colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people passing by. And I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? What they're really saying is, I love you. And I hear babies crying, and I watch them grow, their loin much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, yes, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Oh, yes. Thank you.
Craig Sockel.
Birthday. Hope you're doing well, and very happy that we can celebrate with you remotely. We wish we could be with you, but hope you're having a wonderful day. We're very proud of you. We miss you a lot. Hope we're going to see you soon. And all the best to you for the next 100 years. We love you very much.
And thanks for writing books and sending us copies. And being in Corner Gas.
Happy birthday, Jean. We're very proud of you. And wish also, like Jack, that we could be with you. But since we can't, we're here in Boston letting you know on a beautiful fall day with the trees changing colors. They're gorgeous now. We just hope that this year brings many good things your way and that for the future you continue to experience such great things.
I'm so happy. I mean, David McIntyre, they forgot. Having Kevin do Wonderful World, which I always said I wanted to do. And I've had a chance to hear that. I mean, that is so great. And you're all very special because you're all
having
very...
Carol and me do you.
And Carol and them doing playing nice together. Just as
playing nice together.
And of course, again, with his poetry, his cowboy summer. It's just an absolutely marvelous. I do appreciate it. So thank you. And now I'm going to have another large drink, and then I'm going to go home and put my feet up. Would you like one too?
Oh, I got one, honey.
So thank you all. Thank you.